Thank you, Charlie. Good evening, everyone. I still can't believe it's been 2 years since I was standing in your shoes as the newly elected commander of my chapter. I remember coming to College of Chapters a couple years ago and thinking I had all the answers. And in retrospect, I had no idea what I got myself into. Because as you will soon discover, this next year is likely to be one of the most difficult and challenging of your lives. The responsibility is great. The liability, even more so. But when the stakes are high, so too are the rewards. And tonight, hopefully, I can share with you some advice and some perspective to help you make the most of your term as commander. I want to begin by asking three simple questions. And I think your answer to each of these questions will be a good indicator as to how successful your term will be. First, are you in this for the right reasons? There are two types of leaders in this world. There are those who seek to add value to every endeavor, and those who seek to extract it. As commander, you should be focused on creating value for your organization by leveraging your strengths and the strengths of your members to solve problems. If you're in this for yourself, for a line on a resume or a letter of recommendation, you will almost certainly fail. How can you expect to govern each act by a high sense of honor if your decisions to run for commander in the first place were based on dishonorable motives? You will lose the respect of your members and ultimately yourself. Second, will you be an ethical leader? Much of your curriculum over the past couple days is centered on the concept of ethical leadership. In my opinion, ethical leaders are those who lead with vision and courage. They have a vision of a better future for their organization, and they're willing to make courageous decisions along the way to turn that vision into reality. It didn't surprise me much to find that one of the Latin mottos for the Virginia Military Institute, where we visited today, when translated, reads, by vision and courage. Ethical leadership often involves saying no, and choosing the harder right over the easier wrong. This is no easy task. But make no mistake, your members elected you to lead. They elected you to make the difficult decisions that they themselves are not willing to make. Third, will you leave a lasting legacy? 12 months from now, at the end of your term, will your members be willing and able to fill the void you leave behind? I'm not suggesting you handpick a successor, quite the contrary. But you should identify those members who are capable of filling your shoes, provide them with opportunities to prove themselves, and support and guidance along the way, and then let them compete for the hearts and minds of their would-be constituents. Let them prove that they are capable of leading with vision and courage. One of your most important responsibilities as commander will be to cultivate a sense of ownership amongst your members. You may be their leader, but this is their chapter, and they are stakeholders in both its successes and its failures. Remember, at the end of the day, your obligation to excellence, at its heart, is an obligation to others. Now, having considered those three questions and their implications, some of you may be feeling a little overwhelmed or apprehensive. I certainly did. So allow me to offer some words of comfort. You are not in this alone. College of Chapters has provided you with a roadmap for success, a guidebook for achieving excellence. And as you've seen over the past few days, the fraternity offers a wealth of resources to help you along the way, if, of course, you choose to take advantage of them. You will undoubtedly face adversity, and you will undoubtedly make mistakes. I did. But if you commit yourselves to leading with vision and courage, your alumni and this fraternity will stand beside you every step of the way. But you and only you can make that commitment, and the time to make that commitment is right now. Last year, your predecessors were asked to make the same commitment. Some of them chose to lead with vision and courage. Others chose to maintain the status quo, to accept mediocrity, to shirk their obligation to excellence. And in particular, two commanders from last year come to mind, one from North Carolina, the other from Ohio. Each had inherited a once-strong chapter facing serious operational deficiencies. Each left College of Chapters with a vision and a strategy for achieving that vision, knowing that the survival of his chapter was on the line. But only one of those commanders had the courage to govern his chapter with the high ideals and noble purposes of this fraternity: love, honor, and truth. The other commander saw his chapter's charter suspended and its doors closed on his watch. Tonight, ladies and gentlemen in attendance, please join me in thanking Brother Josh Sherrick from the Zeta Gamma Chapter of Kent State University for his vision and courage and dedication to excellence. The question remains, will you follow Brother Sherrick's example and lead your chapter with vision and courage? I want to share with you three pieces of advice that served me well during my term as commander. The first, simply, is to be kind. Kindness inspires results. People enjoy working for those they enjoy working with. Whenever possible, let your members know that you respect them and appreciate their contributions. Because no matter how hard you try, you simply cannot run a successful chapter on your own. In their book Remarkable, Randy Ross and David Sawyers draw an important distinction between leadership and power. Leadership is about influencing others. Power is about dominating them. And nothing of enduring positive value has ever happened by force. My second piece of advice is to be humble. The position of commander is a thankless one. Your best will never be good enough. Your achievements will be minimized, and your shortcomings will be blown out of proportion. But at the end of the day, if you can look back on your term, knowing that you left it all on the field, you can hold your head high and be proud of the fact that you did your level best. And at the end of the day, what more can anyone ask from you? In times of trial, I often look to a passage called The Penalty of Leadership. The passage comes from a 1915 Cadillac advertisement in the Saturday Evening Post. Cadillac had just introduced the first mass-produced V8 engine automobiles. Their competitors said the move was premature and that the engines were destined to fail. But Cadillac responded, "If the leader truly leads, he remains the leader. Master poet, master painter, master workman, each in his turn has sailed, and each holds his laurels through the ages. That which is good or great makes itself known, no matter how loud the clamor of denial. That which deserves to live, lives." My third and final piece of advice is to have fun. Your experience as commander will serve you well in the real world, and you certainly assume some real world responsibilities, but you're not in the real world yet. Take every opportunity to spend time with your friends and enjoy yourselves. Because while college may be for the best years of your life, it's also for the shortest years of your life. Trust me. I want you to take a moment and look to the individual seated to your left and to your right. Collectively, we represent a diverse group of chapters. For example, Garrett Obers from the Epsilon Mu chapter represents 103 members. Tony Lee from Eta Omicron represents 49. John Paul is the Delta Gamma Chapter's 106th commander. Brendan Hall is Mu Psi's 9th. Glenn Walls leads the Iota Delta Chapter from Harrisonburg, Virginia. Cody Wagner leads Delta Iota from Pullman, Washington. And yet, despite these differences, each of these chapters is on pace to achieve Rock Chapter status. The metrics we use to judge success from one chapter to the other may vary, but ethical leadership is the constant. Vision and courage will always be the keys to success. I want to leave you with the words of General George Patton, best known for his command of the 7th and later the 3rd United States Army in the European Theater of World War II. Patton, an alumnus of the Virginia Military Institute, is remembered for his fierce determination, capable leadership, and ability to inspire men on the battlefield. And he said, "Lead me, follow me, or get the hell out of my way." So gentlemen, I hope you choose to lead. I hope you choose to lead with vision and courage to fulfill your obligation to excellence, because your chapter needs you, this fraternity needs you, and this country needs you desperately. Good luck, Godspeed, and remember, there is no honor in mediocrity. Honor can only be attained through excellence. Thank you.